Getting the expert and Sumit Bagadia from CD Comma Research now joins us in our Mumbai studios here. Sumit, hi, welcome to the show. Let's start with gold and silver. And we have seen a bit of buying come back on those lows in the markets yesterday. How would you want to trade it at this point?
Yeah, Manisha, right. After a sharp correction yesterday, we have seen a small buying in today's session. But I feel today again the market will correct and we can see new lows in today's market. Especially when we talk of gold, I feel gold today can touch levels of around 19,450 and 19,350 levels in the evening session. But if we talk of long-term point of view, I feel a correction till 19,300 will be a very good buy opportunity for long-term players. We can expect a targets of about 20,000 in next one and a half month. When we talk of COMEX level, I feel from present level, gold can give correction till 1325 or $1,320, but those will again be a good buy level for the targets above 1380 and $1,400 in next one and a half month. When we talk of silver, silver has given a very good upside return and from there prices are correcting and silver has given a correction of around 1000 rupees. Still, I feel there should be some more correction. We can see levels of around 35,300 or 35,000 in the evening session. Those levels will be a good buy opportunity for long-term targets of 38,000 and 40,000 by December. So overall, buy on dips for long-term will be a good strategy. And for intraday, at present level, we can sell for lower targets.
Sumit, how about copper? Because that seems to be the only one that has rebounded after yesterday's decline into the markets off its 27-month highs, but we have seen some amount of buying come back. The fundamentals, of course, are on the stronger side. How would you want to play this today and for the slightly medium term?
For base metals, I feel, Manisha, the prices have corrected because of China's news, 25 basis point interest rate hike news. But I feel there should be some more correction from present levels. So when we talk of copper, I feel 372 or 371 will be a good selling levels for intraday for the targets of 367 and 365 levels. And when we talk of medium to long term, somewhere around 365, 362 will be a very good buy opportunity because I'm expecting copper to outperform in the base metal. We can expect targets of around 380 and once if it gives close above 380 levels, then I feel copper will break 400 levels also. So for medium to long term, we expect copper to buy on dips around 362, 365 levels. And purely for intraday, if one wants to trade, one can sell at 371, 372 levels with a stop loss above 375 and downside targets can be 367 and 365 levels purely for intraday.
So we're coming to edible oil space. We have seen some kind of support emerging into that one. Of course, China tightening would not go so well with most of those commodities. But how would you want to trade soybean?
If you remember, Manisha, for soybean from past 2-3 weeks, we have been recommending buy. We were expecting a buy signal in soybean and we had said that we can expect targets of around 2300 and 2400 levels very soon. Now, as we can see that today current contract has expired and we have seen a good appreciation of around 2%. Soybean November contract has been trading somewhere around 20 to 30. I surely expect that soybean can touch levels of 2300 and 2400 levels in next 1 month time horizon. 2270 will be a good resistance. Once prices close about 2270, then we can see targets of around 2400 in next 1 month time frame. I will suggest buy in soybean at around 2210, 2220 with a stop loss of 2180 or 2170 for upside target of around 2300 and 2400 levels in next 1 month.
All right, so Sumit, let you go at that. So that's what he's doing, selling gold and copper for the intraday markets, but buying into soybean is how he sees making money.